The bay here at Cadras is excellent. Although a bit too deep to anchor, there are three heavy private moorings which we were allowed to use for our stay. A large barrier reef protects the bay from the nasty swell we had around the corner in Labadie Bay. Minus the occasional tourist activities, we were completely isolated. There are a few beach houses in the bay as well, but they are usually empty. One of them, however, can be rented out on Airbnb. Looking over the entire bay is the perfect little weekend retreat.
Well, the anchorage here is just about perfect, except for one tiny little inconvenience, and that is there's no cell signal back there, which means no Wi-Fi, no text messaging, no phone calls. And so if you want to make a phone call or check your messages or update Instagram or YouTube comments, you gotta go for a little dinghy ride out here into the bay. Not the worst thing because it's protected by a reef, so it's pretty calm and comfortable, but it makes things a little interesting because the boat is, where's Uma? Uma's way back here, and the cell tower is like just on the other side of this mountain. So right around here out in the middle, you get about 2 bars of cell signal, and you can send text messages. It's an interesting way to start the morning.
What's today?
Today is my birthday!
What are we doing today?
We're going to hang out with a whole bunch of people. It's going to be a great, great day.
What are we actually doing today?
We're taking a group tap-tap boat to go to an awesome beach called Shushu Bay. And it's not very sunny, but we're gonna make it awesome anyway. This is Manu. Manu came for my birthday this weekend. This is what I like it. This is nice. This is gonna be a lot of fun.
Might be a bit wet.
But it's okay because it's my birthday, so whatever happens, we're gonna make it happy.
So it's Kika's birthday, and we're going to an awesome beach. She thinks we're taking a tap-tap boat, but we actually rented out this 62-foot sailboat behind me. She has no idea.
Guess what? Like, they don't know what's
happening. Wait, is it a surprise now? Yeah. Surprise?
You're gonna notice a surprise in about a minute
to many other, like,
if you haven't already.
Like,
we're not taking this boat.
Are we seriously going to be surprised?
Yeah.
No.
You're in coach.
We are
you're going first class.
Going on balance.
Wrong, going first class.
Balancé is another sailboat moored here. She is owned by a local family and used to run charters when the cruise ships are in town. But when there isn't a cruise ship, she can be chartered for private trips around the bay. So for Kika's birthday, we organized a bit of a surprise for her. The day turned out to be a little more rainy than we had hoped, but we don't let a little rain stop us. With enough wind to actually sail, we had a great time anyway. Right when we made it to the island and dropped the anchor, the sun came back out, which made for a pretty perfect day.
After getting a ride back to the boat, everyone jumped off for a quick swim before sailing back. And since it was my birthday, I had to go big. We had a great time, and thanks everyone for such an amazing birthday surprise. And if you want to know more about Balancé, you can check them out on their Instagram.
Hey everybody, my name's Jeremy, this is Sean, and we're here in Haiti working on a really cool project with the Amiga Island Ecological Foundation. Is not something from the outside. It's actually something that was created by two local Haitians who grew up in Cap Haitien in the north, and they grew up on the coast. They watched the reef basically die. Over the past 20 years, it's been really a challenge because the reef has been just falling apart. When you care about something, you're gonna wanna protect it. The idea is obviously to bring in sustainability and to realize that if we take some management steps and we are more careful about how we use our resources, then they're gonna last a lot longer and they're gonna last for future generations. Right now our primary project is a coral restoration program. So we actually get to go diving and grow endangered coral to plant back out onto the reef.
It's a very unique organization to actually be living and working in Haiti. We're one of the only NGOs that currently undertakes a marine conservation project here, specifically fighting the decimation of critically endangered coral species as well. So it's quite a unique setup here and definitely an emerging form of an organization which we're very happy to be a part of, and we'll hopefully, with our assistance, we'll make the organization, the projects, and the population of corals grow. Though we've only been currently running for a little more than a year as an organization, we have quite a few targets that we want to complete in the next 3 to 5 years. And one of those is, in particular, developing relationships with the local fishing communities that are around the north of Haiti. And that's for example, the Labadee fishing villages and also a couple of other small settlements along the north coast of Haiti, because it's these people that are relying on the reefs and the ecosystem services that they provide more than anyone else, whether it's ecotourism or other people that come to Haiti. So these are the people's lives that we really want to impact the most.
It's always fun to have another set of divers around. We love taking people out and showing them what we do and getting people involved.
So if you want to find out more about the work we do and updates on our current project, then feel free to check out our website, our Instagram, and our Facebook, which all the info is for that is in the description below.
I don't know why we never thought about this, but uploading a video from the phone seems to be the best way to do things, because you don't have to haul a big computer everywhere. So today we came to this awesome little restaurant, beach hotel, Belly Beach, that's not far from our boat, but it's a really, really cool place. It's beautiful, and they also serve food, and it's close to the cell phone antenna. So we get really good signal there, so it's great to upload videos. But it's actually the fastest internet we had since we left Miami. So we've been here for less than an hour and it's already 50%. So it's good. And we're enjoying our time. We just ordered some fish and mangoes.
Really ripe.
With the video uploaded at lightning fast speed, it was time to make one last trip into town to run a few errands. Okay, we're heading to town with Will Smith.
Will Smith.
Will Smith.
Will Smith. Will Smith.
Cap Haitien has a long history, stemming back hundreds of years. It's one of the oldest cities of Haiti and is very different than the rest of the country. Life here feels less divided and more welcoming.
Let's see what kind of food they have in there.
We've been told it's a very small market.
There's only one grocery store in town, and it's quite small. But it has the essentials, and if you're lucky enough to get there on a good day, like we were, it has enough to get by. We stocked up on a bit more food to get us to the DR and headed back to Labadee.
We are almost back from getting some groceries and some cash. Last few things on our list before heading to the DR. We hired this guy, Will Smith, for about 20, 25 bucks US. He drove us all the way into Cap and drove us around on our errands and is driving us all the way back out. So that's pretty sweet. We're almost back now. We're gonna hang out with some friends one last time, and then hopefully tomorrow we'll be out of here. Fingers crossed.
We buy drinking water in big 5-gallon jugs here, but finding water to fill our tanks is a bit trickier. Luckily, Robbins, our tap-tap driver, knew exactly what to do. For about $10 US, he filled two huge drums of water and brought it into our boat. Then all we had to do was transfer it onto our tanks. It took a while, but we got it done. This morning we have a funny story for you. So we found something in our dinghy. It's a bag, a trash bag, that somebody put in our dinghy, I guess when we went to town. And we were wondering who it was for and what it was there. So we called a couple people. Turns out, the Wobbins, our boat taxi guy, left this as a present, as a goodbye present for us, because we're friends now, so. And we're about to find out what's inside. So let's do this. Oh, that's super cool. Look at this. He put like a little Haiti box. That's one. Oh, there's so much stuff in there. And then, is it a shirt? It says Harley Davidson shirt. All right, guys, so we are actually about to head out. This is our last little moment in the anchorage, and we're about to pull off the mooring, and we are sailing towards the DR.
With everything done on our to-do list, it was time to cast off the lines and finally leave Haiti. It was nice not to have to haul up the anchor. I don't need nobody else. I got you. We were both a bit sad to leave. We had such a wonderful time here, exploring, learning, and meeting such wonderful people. But we were equally excited to set sail to a new country filled with new adventures just over the horizon. We can leave and run away someday, someday.
Thank you so much for sticking with us all those weeks while we explored Haiti. We love sharing the beauties of this country with all of you. We'll see you next time when we spend a few days downwind sailing to the DR. But until then, cheers!
I have a tendency to lose hats, and this is Kika's Haiti hat, and if I lose it, she'll be really upset with me. I rigged up a drawstring, so no more losing hats. Because once we leave Haiti, I can't get one of these back. We gotta wait for a wind gust. Here we go. Ah, it works. All right.
High five. Boom. Yeah.
Yeah.
Bye-bye to the camera.
Sweet.
And then this guy.
I'm the directing manager.
Yeah, you're the one who says cut.
I'm the one who says cut.